Hi, welcome to this season's Covenant Day, The Bachelor. I'm your host, Chris Harrison. This season is going to be so dramatic. Trust me, it is the most dramatic one ever. Let's get to know your bachelor, Hunter Harbin.
Ladies, I'm perceptive. I can read you. I'm real good. Yeah.
Hello. I'm just a boy from Bama looking for love. My tennis can speak for itself. Check me out if you want. Watch this. Watch it, Sword. Watch it. On the ball.
All right, just one moment. Ooh, sorry about that. He looks like a great guy. We're gonna have an incredible season, but we know how stressful this season gets, so we want to bring in some veterans, some past bachelors, to help him through the time. Let's take a look.
Guys, first off, I'd just like to thank you for being here. I'm just kind of in that stage in my life where I need to make a commitment. So basically, because you guys have gone through the show, The Bachelor, and know more than me, I was just wondering any advice you could give me, because I know y'all are pretty stable in y'all's relationship still.
Well, first off, season's gonna suck because I'm not in it, obviously, but you know, I think you'll be all right. You know, you're a good guy. You got some good qualities. I think there's a young woman out there for you. I really do.
Yeah, just don't be a dead horse.
Well, for $10 a day, you can't go wrong with going to cookout. $10, that's like less than 20.
And Hunter, no matter what else you main thing you need to remember is that you're the catch. They're lucky to be dating you. They're lucky that you are considering them. Never forget.
Guys, I appreciate that.
And I just want to get to the big question. You know, how do I know? How do I know that one of these girls is the right one? You know, I'm doubting myself, you know? There's a lot of insecurities that go into play here. What do I need to know?
Well, Hunter, that's a great question, first of all. And I want to thank you for asking that question, because it is just a great question. And I think with me, you just look her in the eye, and you just know, you know? You just know.
So, James, I realize you aired in 09, was it? 09? How did cookout play as a factor in your role as The Bachelor in 2009, you know?
Well, I used it as like a way to judge the women. If I took them there and they were insulted, then I knew that obviously they weren't the one for me. And that's probably why I was the only Bachelor ever not to have a woman come out.
Would you cut that out?
Rob.
Trying to do an interview here.
It's a slinky.
Just cut it out.
Guys, I just want to thank you for being here. Incredible opportunity to me to be able to ask you guys questions and further help my experience coming onto The Bachelor in this 2015 season. I appreciate it.
Yeah, you know, I appreciate that. I really do. It means a lot. One more thing. I just want to tell you, when you find that young thing, that pretty young, that woman, then you know what you're going to do. You're going to take the key. You're going to unlock her heart.
Oh, yeah?
And you're going to be with her for the rest of your life.
Thanks, Peter. Bless you.
I need a moment.
Man, those guys gave him some great advice. I'm sure Hunter's going to walk away knowing all he needs to know about the show. Just so you remember, I'm Chris Harrison, the Chris Harrison. Well, this season, we have incredible drama. We've got girls fighting. We've got many girls falling in love with Hunter. It's going to be an incredible season.
What's going on? How are you?
Hey, good. How are you?
I'm doing well.
I'm Jamie. I'm going to Harding University, and I actually brought you an application because I don't think it's going to work out if you don't come with
me.
Thanks.
I'll keep
no
that
problem.
In mind.
Session C.
How's it going?
Hey, can you help me lift my veil?
You got a veil?
Yeah.
Nice.
Hi.
What'd you get a veil for?
I'm Annie.
What'd you?
Because
I'm
this
Hunter.
Is just like a fairy tale. I think we're perfect for each other. But don't worry, I've got everything figured out.
All right, I'm glad you have everything figured out.
The second I saw Hunter, all I could think about was that gorgeous cushion-cut 3-carat diamond ring I wanted. And of course, I've been picking out dresses forever. He's everything I ever wanted. He's the Southern gentleman from Alabama, and I know we're gonna live on a plantation, and I can already see our two little kids, Sally, Paige, and Shepherd, running around with our dog, Bo, and Lupo, just like Kate Middleton. Oh my gosh, I can just already see my life with him. I just can't wait to marry him. He's gonna pick me, right? Hey!
How
sorry,
you?
Am I late? Good, how are you? Hi.
Need some help with that?
Hi, I'm Maddie. No, I'm
fine.
You sure
you don't need some help?
Yeah, I'm good. Hi.
All right, how's your day been?
Good. Oh my gosh, hey, it's so
nice
to meet
you.
Can we take a picture?
Yeah,
what's
your name again?
At @Mare_Lewis.
Okay,
1, 2, 3, smile. Okay, thanks, I'll tag you. Future hub.
I'm so fresh, man. Man, y'all scared to do it.
I'm Hannah Grace Knight.
I'm Hunter.
I didn't realize we were coming from tennis tryouts.
Yeah, the weather's nice today.
Is it?
Well, good conditions to play in.
I see.
Yeah.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
So like I just met Hunter and I have to be honest, like it's a little bit disappointing. He's a lot shorter than I was expecting. I guess maybe the camera made him look a little bit taller. And I can spy knockoffs from a mile away. Like, I don't know who he thinks he's fooling, but I'm just not really sure what to think right now. Disappointment is flowing through my mind, really, so.
How are you?
Hi, it's nice to meet you.
It's nice to meet you, too.
Where are you from?
Alabama.
Okay, bye.
How's it going?
It's going well.
What's your name?
Julia.
It's nice to meet you.
You may bow.
Okay. What's going on?
Hey, what's up, bro?
How are
you? Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. What's going on?
Oh, hi.
How are you?
Good, I'm Julia.
I'm Hunter.
Nice to meet you.
You got something on your mind?
No, I'm just ready to see how this goes, ready to move on. Yeah. I decided to come on The Bachelor because I'm just trying to move on from a previous relationship. Cameron was my ex-boyfriend, and I'm just really trying to move on. I have really good intentions. I really like Hunter, but I'm just really afraid he's gonna find me. I've been debating a restraining order, but hopefully it'll all end up really well.
How are you?
I'm just so tired, and I've got it. Headache,
and I just can't
do this anymore. I'm so
what?
I can't do this.
You want some water?
No.
I'm sorry.
I can't. I'm done. Goodbye.
What's going on? How are you?
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. I'm Annie.
I'm Hunter.
Just find me inside, okay?
Okay.
Hi,
how are you?
It's so good to meet you.
I'm so glad I finally got to meet you.
You look
great.
Thank you. I'm Alex.
Like boots. I'm Hunter.
Nice to meet you.
It's about time we got a selling girl around here.
Oh yeah, for sure. Well, great to meet you. I'll see you inside.
This season on The Bachelor, love will blossom. Romance will bud. The heat will rise. Tears may fall. Drama. Scandal. Heartbreak. Who will Hunter choose?
I know she's here. I haven't seen her in days, but I know she's here. I gotta find her. Girl, I don't know what I'm gonna do with her. Julia, you in here? No. Jolene, you can't hide if you're in here. I'm gonna find you. Where the heck? Julia? Nope. Have you seen her? I'm gonna find her. Wait, this is her locker. Maybe she left something in here. Oh, where is she? Julia? What the heck? Come on. Julia? You know what? She says she wants space. I can't give her space. I start CrossFit for her. I make good grades for her. Like, she says she wants space. If you've got arms this big, there's not space that's gonna be there. You know what? I'm so done with this. I'm gonna dye my hair.
Guys, I am so glad Hunter's letting us have this pool party.
Oh my gosh, me
yes.
too.
It's time to show off our one piece.
I just don't know what to do. I don't know if I should be here or if I should go home. And I don't know what I think of him. I mean, it's like the other girls, they hate me and like they don't include me.
My picture with Hunter only got 95 likes. Do you think I should delete it? Ugh, oh my gosh, my hair looks so bad. Ooh, Snapchat. Hey.
I'm so fresh, man. Man, y'all scared to do it how I do it.
Guys, I think Annie A has a boyfriend back home. I was thinking she wasn't here for the right reason.
Are you serious? Wait, someone
oh
should
my
really.
God!
Guys, someone really should tell Hunter about that.
I know. I don't know. I don't want to mess up my time with him.
Well, but if she has a boyfriend,
it's better our
Why
chances.
Why would she cheat like that?
These girls are making up lies about me. They're trying to like create my doom. I swear, we're just friends. I promise. I had to tie up some loose ends. I'm here for Hunter. That's all I can say.
I'm sorry. What did McCory show up in?
I have no idea.
That scares me.
That was really frightening. But I mean, have you seen everybody else's one pieces? Like, I think
so
ours
athletic.
Win. Ours win because athletic. Ooh, athletic
Sick.
One pieces.
Sick. Oh my gosh, I think we're gonna be the
I
last
think we'll be
two
the top two. Yeah.
And what's up with that girl crying? Like, get a life.
She'll be saved again.
Oh my god. And that girl who thinks she's gonna marry Hunter. Oh please, that's so tacky.
Oh my gosh, I can't believe she showed up and did that. Oh,
that's so embarrassing. That
Bless
embarrasses
her heart.
Me.
Mm. Oh, hello, Annie P. I said white, not cream. It's a June wedding. Ugh, get it right.
So who do you think is gonna get the final rose?
I don't know.
Cameron. Oh my gosh, what? He's here. He found me. Oh my gosh, he found me! Oh my god!
All right, girls, I have this special place to show you guys. It's called Cookouts, 5-star venue. Take a lot of girls here, but take a seat.
I love it.
It's so romantic.
Good. You guys ready to take some orders?
Yeah.
What do you want?
What do you feel about Trey?
Oh, the tray. Trey's a big play. You guys should get the tray. You get a quesadilla. How you guys feel about the date?
I told him in the first interview that you can always judge a person's heart by what they order at Cookout. Look who's right, this guy.
It's really romantic. Such a gorgeous atmosphere. I love it here.
You guys should definitely try the tray.
Oh yeah.
Maybe throw some chicken nuggets in there that are out of this world, I'm telling you. Beats some the palm. Guys. Palm's got nothing on this place. Hush puppies? Their hush puppies are the best. You gotta get them dipped in the buffalo with the ranch. So good.
Yes.
Ever been to Chima? Beats it by a mile. Beats it by a mile, I'm telling you right now.
Whatever
this
you
place
say.
Is this place is the place to go in Charlotte, North Carolina.
Yes.
You ask anyone around here, they tell you Cookout. You can go to the Palm, you can go to Chima's. You can go to Sushi 101. I'm telling you right now, their chicken nuggets are out of this world.
Hunter just has such a generous heart. I mean, the fact that he was that willing to get a tray for me, I feel like he really knows and cares about me. Maybe even more than Jamie.
Alright, first of all, I just wanted to say that based off what you guys ordered, the trays, it's really going to make my decision very hard because I feel like I feel like I know y'all's hearts better. Like, it's really going to come down to the wire with you two. I did like how you picked the tray. I would have recommended the corn dog, though. I should have recommended the corn dog. I'm sorry about that.
I'm just so frustrated with myself because I should have ordered the corn dog. He knows it's better, but he didn't recommend it, so I think maybe he'd still choose me, but I'm really concerned. Like, I thought about ordering it, and now I just feel like maybe he won't choose me because he said he knows my heart, but really my heart's with the corn dog. So I'm just really frustrated, really nervous, and...
Welcome back, America. We're here on a beautiful Clemson Orange Friday. I'm with Hunter. I wanted to catch up with him, see how the season's going. So Hunter, is there any girl in specific you've got your eye on?
Come on, I said on Julia.
Julia...
Godly.
Oh, I've heard great things about her.
Oh, she's a great girl, you know.
She is.
I think she has good intentions, mm-hmm. and I think that'd fit my... what I want in a relationship with a woman.
Great, that's great. Well, good. Good luck on that. Is there anything really stressing you out?
It's just a lot. You know, I said I'm in Julia, but at the same time, I'm kind of torn between some people. And I don't know if it's just my insecurities coming out of me.
I just feel like Andy's going by my back. I know there's someone else there.
I've seen you. You have really good chemistry with her, so I understand what you're going through.
I'm just perceptive. Like, I just know. I know there's someone else there, and I don't know how to handle it.
We've handled these kind of situations before.
I don't
so
know because I.
If you want us to bring in Annie, we can.
I don't want her in here. I don't want her in here. She. If I'm not the guy for her, that's her decision.
You're taking the high road on this. But if it gets worse, we can definitely talk about it. I can sit down and talk to her alone about it.
Appreciate you, man. Appreciate you.
Thanks for coming.
He's obviously gonna choose me.
That's what you like to make.
Tore my ACL and I'm gonna have to get surgery. Like, is this a joke? Because I'm here for Hunter, but I don't know if I can deal with these people. Like, the surgery, I mean, I might make it next month, but like, I really want to keep competing for him. Like, he's just so cute and his personality is so good. And so I don't know, the surgery will just, it'll be on my own time.
Teachers and students, please pardon the interruption. Following second period, everybody should please report to the rose ceremony. Thank you.
This is the first rose ceremony. Hunter, here's your first rose.
Chris.
Good luck, ladies.
Girls, first off, I'd just like to say, you know, how hard this is. Get to know you all so well. And... you know, it's just like life, you gotta make decisions, and this is gonna be one of my harder decisions, but I've gotta make a choice. Julia. Take this rose. It's Chris. Alex. Meredith. Jamie. Glory.
Annie.
I can't do it. I'm sorry. Sorry. Sorry.
It's okay.
I can't.
It's
I still love him.
It's okay.
No, no, I'm not doing this. Get the camera on my face. Get out. I'm gone.
This place I'm going to show you, I like to call it a tropical oasis. Aquaponics.
Are you kidding me?
It's freaking awesome.
Aquaponics? That is sick. Are you kidding? I felt a strong connection between us, but now I'm just not sure.
Got more green in here than you could ever imagine. Take a look. This is my tomato bush. Pretty tropical. Got some wires to keep things sorted out.
Come here, take a look. Take a look.
Just some fly larvae. Don't mind it. Got some fish in here. We feed them night and day. Some water if you want to drink some. You thirsty?
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. A lot of green. We run this day and night, 8 a.m. 5 p.m. It's a pretty good situation we got going here, but are you pleased?
Sick.
I know, it's awesome. Yeah, it got pretty steamy in the greenhouse, but I know for a fact she likes me. I can see it, I can feel it. I know she does.
Lies. Cheating. Love comes at a high price. Who will fight for it? Will there be a happy ending? Welcome back to the final rose ceremony. Hunter, good luck with your decision.
Guess it's time for my final decision. I hate that it's come down like this, but Julia.
Whoa, hey, I finally found her and this is what I get?
Some secret bachelors is what we like to call them. We've had dates, we've had broken hearts, we've had really bad dates, so we just thought we'd share them with y'all and show them what not to do on the date. Let's take a look.
Hey babe, how you doing?
Hi, I'm good, thanks.
Ready for our first date?
Yeah, sure.
I got you this pine cone with a dandelion planted in it.
Oh, that's so nice.
It's a Native American symbol for first date luck.
Yeah.
Okay, so for our first date, we're going to be doing a 10-mile hike in the mountains.
Hike?
Yeah, come on, you ready?
No, these aren't hiking shoes.
Oh, it's okay.
What are you doing?
Come on, let's go, trust me.
No, like, what are you doing?
We're going for a 10-mile hike.
Okay.
Scavenger hunt, too. We're going to find some, like, eel eggs and, like,
Like on the ground?
Like bones and things.
Bones?
Yeah, it's just fun. Right, come okay. on, trust me.
Okay, so what are we looking for?
Hey, look what I found.
What? What
it's
is
a
it?
Fungus.
It's a stick. It's a wood.
It's edible.
It's a wood.
Try it.
That's not that. What is it? What is that? Chips?
Native Americans eat it. Come on, babe, let's go. Come on.
What is this, like Tarzan? Am I Tarzan and Jane now?
We're gonna find eel eggs. They give you strength. Right here.
That's the skinniest tree you've ever seen. You're gonna climb that tree?
Yeah, but there's eels at the top and they have eggs that boost endorphins. Are you ready? Let's go. Come on, follow me. Okay. There's eagle legs up here.
Okay, these aren't the shoes, John. Oh my gosh, John.
I got some eagle legs.
Okay.
All right, next thing on the list is dream catchers from Mount Sinai. You ready?
No, I'm not ready. I'm done.
Hey, Matthew McKnight, student body president, Covenant Day School. Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you. So tell me about yourself. Where are you from? Where are you going to college? I know that you go to Covenant Day, but
yeah.
Tell me about yourself.
Well, I'm actually from Birmingham, Alabama.
Birmingham.
And
okay. I played soccer tournament there once.
Oh, cool.
We got third.
Yeah, it's nice. I'm going to join a sorority. I'm so excited about it. And it's like the only one.
I'm president of student council. That's kind of close.
Yeah. Yeah, it is. Anyway, so in the sorority, you do like swaps with other frats, and I'm like really excited. You go to social events, and you go to dances.
I plan socials, I plan dances.
Yeah. And then...
You know, did you know that women were not even allowed to dance in public until like the 20th century? I mean, you know, you look at people like Susan B. Anthony and Abigail Adams. Without those ladies, you wouldn't even be able to do what you do, so that's great. Yeah. What a great history of social progression we have here in the United States.
Yeah. Anyways, so I'm going to go to a bunch of football games in the stadium, Alabama Stadium. I'm so excited. It's going to be so much fun, and I'll get to go to every
game. Did you know that Harvard University had the first ever collegiate football team, and the University of Chicago had the first ever Heisman Trophy winner? And those two schools aren't even good at football anymore.
So I think at Alabama they're getting like a new president. Which is, I think, it's political.
That's great. Yeah, well, it's not technically political, but I tell you what, political presidents are super interesting. I tell you what, my top five favorite presidents, in no particular order, I don't want to offend anybody here, would probably, number one, Abraham Lincoln. Can't go wrong. Let us out of the Civil War. Number two and three would probably be Andrew Jackson and FDR, kind of the bad boys of politics. Number four would probably be Thomas Jefferson, one of the greatest politicians of all time. And then number five, you have to say JFK. What a monumental figure in American history, right?
Yeah, so anyways, do you like Miley Cyrus?
Yeah. I love Miley Cyrus.
Really?
No, but it's okay if you like her. It's okay. I know Bangers is supposed to be great, so I'm sure a lot of people seem to like her a lot. Don't think that the wrong way. So, have you seen the news about this whole like Russia invading Crimea and stuff?
No, I don't really watch the news.
Oh, that's okay. That's okay. Not everyone has to watch the news. I just like to. You know, what's interesting is that everyone thinks that Russia's just invading Crimea out of the blue, but really, when you look into history, Russia's always had Crimea. You know, in the USSR, Crimea was a part of Russia. And going back even further, you look at Peter the Great and Ivan the Terrible and all those guys, Crimea's been in there for a long time. So when you really put historical context around it, it actually makes it really interesting.
I just forgot that I have this thing that I need to go do. And you can stay here, but like, it was great meeting you.
Oh, great meeting you too, Stephanie.
Yeah.
We'd love to see you again sometime.
So, yeah, I'll see you around. I gotta go do this thing that I forgot to do.
I'm so sorry. Did I offend you? Express yourself. Express yourself. How you doing?
Chris?
Yeah.
Nice to meet you.
Kristen? Kristen, right?
Yes.
Like 10 of Chris.
Yes.
That's awesome. Why don't you take a seat?
Thanks.
Great. Great to see you.
You too.
Oh, yeah. What do you like?
I like...
Cool.
Yeah? Awesome.
Oh, yeah?
What do you like?
Well, my favorite color is red. I don't know if you knew that, but I do. And I'm telling you now, so hopefully you'll remember it. And so if you ever buy me any gifts or anything like that, that'd be great. So what are your favorite things about me so far? Anything? Awesome?
You know, I'm not sure this is going to work out.
You know... For you to say something like that right here, right now, that just tears me apart. That shatters my universe. I cannot believe it!
Space Force in here!
Oh!
No!
What? What?
No! This is a quiet zone, and I am reading my paper. Now get out of here.
Most of all, get up and run.